يوافي نعمه ويكافئ مزيده. الحمد لله أكرم الأكرمين، الحمد لله ينفق بالليل والنهار، خزائنه ملأى ويداه سحاء الليل والنهار. انظروا كم أنفق منذ خلق السماوات والأرض، سبحانه هو الوهاب، سبحانه هو الغني، سبحانه من لجأ إليه أعطاه ومن دعاه أجابه، سبحانه سبحانه. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وإمام الخلق وصفي الرحمن وخليله، أرسله ربه بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله، فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة. أرسله الله رحمةً للعالمين، فكان أكرم الخلق وأجودهم، كان أجود بالخير من الريح المرسلة صلى الله عليه وسلم. ما سئل شيئًا قط فقال لا، ما قال لا قط إلا في تشهده، لولا التشهد كانت لاؤه نعم. فاللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهديه واستنى بسنته واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. الضعفاء، the weak amongst in our community and in the world. After praising Allah and testifying that there is no God except Allah and that the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best of all messengers sent with the message of guidance, we are talking in those few minutes inshallah tabaraka wa ta'ala about the weak in any community. That sector of any community that needs more attention. Inna Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala ma ja'al al-faqra 'ayban. It's not a fault in the person to be poor, to be weak. Inna Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala ma ja'al al-ibtila'a إلا ليختبر الناس. Allah is not testing people and He is testing everybody in different ways. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not a sign of His displeasure that He tests somebody. He tested the prophets. وأشد الناس بلاء الأنبياء. وإذا كان الابتلاء في الرزق فإن الناس غالبا ما يجزعون. One of the most important areas of ابتلاء that people usually show less patience when they face is poverty, is lack of resources, lack of money. وأول رسالة للفقراء ولمن كان حظه من هذه الدنيا قليل عليه بالتسليم والرضا. فإن جنة الرضا في التسليم لما قدر الله وقضى. The first message for those who suffer lack of resources, lack of money, lack of risk, is that we should submit to the will of Allah and accept it as one of قضاء الله تبارك وتعالى وقدره. That's number one. وليعلم كل إنسان أن ما أصاب كما قال الله عز وجل ما أصاب من مصيبة إلا بإذن الله ومن يؤمن بالله يهدي قلبه. Nothing, no calamity, no test that's happening except that it happens by the permission of Allah, and whoever has faith in Allah, Allah will cause his heart to calm down. Allah will send reassurance to his heart. فاللهم اهد قلوبنا لما نزل بنا يا رب العالمين. وليعلم كل إنسان أن نفسا كما في الحديث لن تموت حتى تستكمل رزقها وأجلها. No soul shall die before getting in full the full risk, the provision that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided for that soul. والله تبارك وتعالى كتب الرزق من ضمن ما كتب. ففي الحديث إن أحدكم يجمع خلقه في بطن أمه حتى قال إن الملك يؤمر بكتب أربع كلمات ومنها رزقه. From the beginning when the person was a fetus in the womb of his mother, Allah سبحانه وتعالى sends this angel to record down four things. One of the four things is the رزق, the provision, how much he is going to take in this life. And nobody will die, will come to an end before taking it, taking that thing that's decided for him in full. النفس تجزع أن تكون فقيرة والفقر خير من غنى يطغيها وغنى النفوس هو الكفاف فإن أبت فجميع ما في الأرض لا يكفيها. إن الغنى الحقيقي هو غنى النفس. Being rich is being rich from within. Is not the richness of means. Because if the soul is not rich enough, is not sufficient, not feeling that it's sufficient by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving to you is good for you, if that is there, then even if you have the entire, what's in the entire earth, it's not going to be enough for such a soul. ليعلم كل إنسان أنه لو اجتمع كل من في الأرض من ملوك وأمراء ووزراء وأقوياء وغيرهم ليسقوه شربة ما كتبها الله لم يكن ذلك. If all people in the entire earth, kings, everybody who has power, they gather together to give you something as little as a sip of water that Allah did not plan for you to happen, it's not going to happen. And if they, all of them decide, come together, gather together to stop something as little as anything that it could be that Allah decides that it will happen to you, they will never be able to prevent this from happening. فتقسيم الأرزاق نحن قسمنا بينهم معيشتهم في الحياة الدنيا هو أمر إلهي. It's Allah's job that He decides who takes what. He gives the shares. He said, "We, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the royal we, divided the arzaq, the provisions in this life." ولا يسأل عما يفعل وهم يسألون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not to be questioned why He is giving more, she is getting less. Why this is like that? That's not the right question from believers or non-believers, because nobody can change the plan of Allah. Allah plans His universe the way He wants, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَوْ كَانَتِ الْأَرْزَاقُ تَجْرِي عَلَى الْحِجَى هَلَكْنَا إِذًا مِنْ جَهْلِهِنَّ الْبَهَائِمُ وَلَمْ يَجْتَمِعْ شَرْقٌ وَغَرْبٌ لِقَاصِدٍ وَلَا الْمَجْدُ فِي كَفِّ امْرِئٍ وَالدَّرَاهِمُ. Nobody can get everything at the same time. Talking about rizq, it might be a little short in the arzaq in money, but you are, if you look at everything, the totality of what you got, you will see that you get a lot of things that other people do not get. And if it's only by how intelligent the person is, or from what family, or this or that, then the animals, the beasts, would not have any share because they don't have much of plans, but they work. مقدمة سريعة أن الرزق والنصر وكل ما في يعني ما في الدنيا يرتبط بأسباب مادية وأسباب معنوية. There are two causes for specifically الرزق والنصر. To get victory, to be victorious, to be ممكن, established on earth, or to get provision. There are two reasons for that. Tangible, one that's tangible, and one that's moral. The tangible, we are not discussing much today. الأرزاق المادية هي التي والنصر المادي هو الذي أمر الله به في يعني بالأخذ بأسبابه فيما أمر فقال وأعدوا لهم ما استطعتم من قوة. أمر بالأخذ بأسباب النصر المادية وأمر بالأخذ بأسباب الرزق المادية فقال فامشوا في مناكبها أسعوا إذا فاسعوا. فالله سبحانه وتعالى order you to take and adopt the tangible reasons when he said if you want to be victorious prepare as much power as you can to face your enemy so you get victory. And in terms of rizq, he said, go in the earth, walk around. وَأَمَرَ بِالْمُهَاجَرَ وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعًا. قَدْ يَبْحَثُ الْإِنسَانُ عَنْ رِزْقٍ فِي مَكَانٍ فَتَتَعَثَّرُ أُمُورُهُ وَلَوْ سَافَرَ وَهَاجَرَ وَطَلَبَهُ فِي مَكَانٍ آخَرُ لَا وَجَدَ سَعَدًا كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ فِي الْآيَةِ. You might try to do a business somewhere or something, follow your rizq in a certain way or in a certain place. It's not going as you are planning. Maybe if you travel somewhere else, try this business in a different place. As Allah said in the ayah, whoever travels, migrates on earth, he might find مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا, he might find, you know, abundance if he tries a different strategy. But we are not discussing those tangible reasons, but at the same time, we are not ignoring them. Those are, this is 50%. The other 50%, الأسباب المعنوية وما النصر إلا من عند الله. والله يرزق إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. So the rizq, the nasr is mainly from Allah. There is some religious aspect for it that حين يضع العبد توكله ورضاه بما قدر الله ويضع ثقته في الله. When you put your trust fully in Allah سبحانه وتعالى, just like the companions, تعد ما استطعت من أسباب نصر المادية, you adopt all the tangible reasons to get rizq, to get victory, but then you fully depend on Allah, like Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the companions, and all the prophets, even though they were outnumbered, they were victorious. And the minute they look at how big they are, how many tangible reasons they got, it will happen to them, what happened to them on the day of Hunayn, وَيَوْمَ حُنَيْنٍ إِذْ أَعْجَبَتْكُمْ كَثْرَتُكُمْ فَلَمْ تُغْنِ عَنْكُمْ شَيْئًا. فالاعتماد على الأسباب المادية لا يليق بالمؤمن, هذا لغير المؤمنين. Just solely depending on the tangible reasons, this is for non-believers mainly. Believers would depend on the tangible reasons and more importantly on the asbab al-ma'nawiyya, the moral reasons and causes to do that. Wallahu tabarak wa ta'ala kathiran ma rabata rizqa al-mu'minina bi-infaqihim wa'allaka imanahum bi-infaqi kulli ibadiy alladhina amanu yuqimu s-salata wa yunfiqu mimma razaqnahum sirran wa alaniya ya ayyuha alladhina amanu la tulhikum amwalukum wa la awladukum an dhikrillah ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول رب لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in many ayat that true believers we give them and they spend from what we give them. And he said the one wish that somebody after death would hope to come back to life so he would fulfill, the one wish is فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Oh Allah, if you just bring me back to life so I give in sadaqah, so I spend in charity and be amongst the righteous, why would he say that? لِمَاذَا يَتَمَنَّ الْمُتَمَنِّينَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهِمْ أَنْ يَعُودُوا إِلَى الدُّنْيَا أَوَّلَ مَا يَتَمَنَّوْنَ لِأَصَّدَّقَ فَأَصَّدَّقَ. So that they give charity. Why is that? Because they see how much of reward they get. لما يرونه من عظم أجر وجزاء الصدقة حينئذ ولما يعطيهم الله تبارك وتعالى عليه. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحث الصحابة كما في حديثه أنفق بلالا ولا تخش من ذي العرش إقلالا. If you are afraid that spending, giving away for the poor and needy people, for those who are in need, and you are afraid that that will cause you to lose, it would decrease what you have, it's not going to happen. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in many ahadith promised, like this piece of advice is given to Bilal radiallahu anhu, he said, spend and never be afraid that of the decrease that will happen to you because of you spending. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to cause decrease to happen to your risk when you spend for his cause. You spend for his cause, yes, it looks like a decrease, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you much more in return for that. وَيَعْنِي بَشَّرَ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم أَنَّهُ لَا حَسَدَ إِلَّا فِي اثْنَتَيْنِ رَجُلٌ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ مَالًا فَسَلَّطَهُ عَلَى هَلَكَتِهِ فِي الْحَقِّ. This is one of the areas that people should really compete and envy one another, not the negative kind of envy, but just looking very high at what that person would do. He said, a person that Allah gives him abundance of rizq, money, and then فَسَلَّطَهُ عَلَى هَلَكَتِهِ فِي الْحَقِّ, and he is literally spending to, you know, maximum, to the maximum of that money in various ways of truth, of establishing good things, in charity. So this is really something that deserves, you know, competition. وفي الحديث ذهب أهل الدثور بالأجور يصلون كما نصلي ويصومون كما نصوم. The people who got abundance, the rich people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet is saying, they got majority of the reward. They got majority of the reward. Why? Because they pray like the weak and poor people pray. They fast like them, like the poor people fast, but then they spend of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given them. وَالْيَدُ الْعُلْيَا خَيْرٌ مِنَ الْيَدِ السُّفْلَى وَقُصِّدَ بِهَا الْيَدُ الَّتِي تُنْفِقُ هِيَ الْيَدُ الْعُلْيَا وَمَنْ تَصَدَّقَ بِعَدْلِ تَمْرَةٍ مِنْ كَسْبٍ طَيِّبٍ وَلَا يَقْبَلُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا الطَّيِّبَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُهَا بِيَمِينِهِ ثم يربيها لصاحبه كما يربي أحدكم فلوه أي مهره حتى تكون مثل الجبل. الحديث الآخر إنها تكون لقمة ثم تأتي ثم يراها في ميزان حسناته كالجبل. You might spend as little as half of a date, as little of a, as one bite, a small piece of food that you give it to somebody who's hungry, and you see it in the scale of your deeds. In the day of judgment, like a mountain of reward, as in the hadith, as a mountain. وَالْمَرْءُ يَأْتِي فِي ظِلِّ صَدَقَتِهِ. The person will come. It's not meant, by the way, for any, there's no fundraising or anything. But it's good to remind one another sometimes when we are not asking you to spend or kind of, you know, putting pressure on you. This is not meant for any of that. But it's just a reminder that we have weak people. We have here in America. Everywhere in the world. I got some statistics in here. One out of five, that's one
fifth
of the world, more than a billion, more than a billion people, أكثر من مليار إنسان على وجه الأرض يبيتون ليلهم يتضورون من الجوع لا يجدون ما يأكلون. معظمهم في جنوب شرق آسيا وفي أفريقيا وفي هذه الدول. So there's one fifth of the people of the world who spend their night not having enough food like this. They go hungry. They go hungry. That's one fifth of the world. And it's not because of the lack of the resources or something. Because on the other hand, that's the problem of capitalism. One of the problems of the system of capitalism. You know, abundance will be there in the hands of a few people, and then majority of people are suffering. As it is even here in the States, 1% of people, they have more than 40%, I think, of the resources or like equal, they equal what the other 40% of Americans got, just 1% of people. And you can go and review the statistics by the United Nations and FAO, the FAO organization, all of these. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من رسائل طبعا ما لنا يعني نبغي زيادة الرزق وهذا شيء فطري كل إنسان يبغي أن يزيد رزقه وطبعا هناك الأسباب المادية والأسباب كذا وكثير من أسباب. A lot of causes to increase to cause you to have more abundant money and I'm not saying this is only the reasons of increase but this is a few of them. One of them أسباب معنوية is one of the moral reasons is to take care of the weak, to take care of the poor. وهل ترزقون وتنصرون إلا بضعفائكم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying, and do you think why in the world you are being given rizq, provision, money, and given victory except because of the weak amongst you? قال ابن بطال المالكي أحد العلماء يقول إن لأن الضعفاء والمساكين حين يدعون الله يدعونه بإخلاص يدعون يسألونه النصر بإخلاص يسألونه الرزق بالإخلاص لقلة تعلقهم بزخرف الدنيا مما لا يكون لغيرهم فيعني يجيبهم الله تبارك وتعالى لذلك. It's mainly you're giving victory and rizq because of those people who are making dua, the weak, the poor, making dua for the ummah, making dua for everybody. And they make it sincerely because they having bliss to have with this life and they are not attached like other people to what's in this life. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to their dua more than he responds to others. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يقول ابغوني بضعفائكم فإنما ترزقون وتنصرون بضعفائكم. He said if you want to try, Prophet is saying if you want to come closer to me, if you want to get my love and so be good to your poor and your the weakest amongst you. وهذا عبد الله بن عمر من أصحابه وأبوه قبله عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه يتتبعه طلحة. May I ask the brothers to move forward? Please move forward. Make more room, inshallah. The brothers are still coming. So طلحة عمر كل يوم هو خليفة يذهب إلى ناحية من نواحي المدينة ويدخل بيتا بعينه في أول النهار وأحيانا في آخره. عمر بن الخطاب, he is the خليفة, the president, the one who's in charge of the entire, you know, believers in this big state, and he is coming to one specific house every day, and then leaving. Talha is following him, and he figured out that I need to investigate that. He investigated it, and then he got to this house, he found the lady. وجد امرأةً عمياء عجوزًا مقعدة. He found a handicapped person, blind person, a very old person, and he asked her, what is this man that comes to you every day do? And she said, يرفع عني الأذى ويعني كأنها قالت يطبخ لي ويأكل. He takes full care of me. He takes the trash out every day. I don't even know him. She's blind. She doesn't know who he is. This is the Khalifa. This is the president. This is Amir al-Mu'mineen, the commander of the believers. If he wishes, he would assign somebody to do it, but he wants to do it himself, radiallahu anhu, to go all the way to the house of this lady who doesn't have anybody to take care of her, and he would take the trash, he would cook the food, he would clean the house, and everything. Abu Bakr did the same thing. Abdullah ibn Umar, ما كان يأكل أكلةً يعني ما كانت يهنأ له طعام إلا ويدعو مسكيناً يأكل معه. Abdullah ibn Umar, the son of Umar ibn al-Khattab, never in the world that he eats once except that he invites somebody of the weak people, poor people to eat with him. Those are our examples, أيها الأكارم. وكان أخير الناس للمسكين جعفر بن أبي طالب الذي كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يكنيه بأبي المساكين. The uncle of the Prophet جعفر بن أبي طالب, the cousin of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Nabi called him or gave him the nickname of the father of the weak or the needy because he always take extra care of them. فما أحوجنا أيها الأكارم لي يعني السير على خطى هؤلاء. Let's take care of our poor. They are everywhere. The needy is everywhere. Not only those who come and ask. Yes, إن للسائل حقا ولو أتى على فرس كما في بعض الآثار. A person who is asking, he has a right somehow. Even though he is coming on the back of a horse, like you think he is not in need. وَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَرْ. If somebody is asking, do not, you know, talk to them in a harsh way. Do not, they have a right somehow. Anybody who is asking. And more importantly, those who do not ask. يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ أَغْنِيَاءَ مِنَ التَّعَفُّفِ. Some people are modest enough. They don't want to ask. Even though they are in need, and if somebody looks at them, you think they are sufficient and they are good because they are not, you know, they have modesty that prevents them from asking. If it's not for the believers and those who have abundance to go and take care of them, who will take care of them? We have the orphans. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لما يذكر لنا هذه إن شئت فقول الوصايا العشر يقول واعبدوا الله ولا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا ثم يعدد وبذي القربى واليتامى والمساكين والجار ذي القربى آخر ما ذكره. Allah said that number one thing you have to do is worship Allah alone, توحيد, never associating anybody with him. وبالوالدين, right after his right he said, and then comes the right of the parents. وبذي القربى, and then comes the right of the poor. أدناك أدناك, the one that you should take care of the most are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then taking care of your parents, and then the closest to you, the relatives, the orphans, the needy. How many orphans we have around us? How many needy? How many widow women that do not have anything, and they, many of them do not ask, even in our community, in this very community. So let's go and seek those and spend on them because it's not for them. وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلِأَنفُسِكُمْ. Whatever you spend in goodness, it's for your own self. It's for your own self. We have so many organizations and we have so many efforts. That's so good. And that's why, according to the statistics of the United Nations, this hunger statistics is, those who go hungry is 17% less in 2014 than it used to be back in 1990. That's because of so many efforts of organizations and so on. Let's do our best. ولا نفكر هذا التفكير الاستقطابي أو هذا التفكير one-way minded. إنه إذا ننفق هناك ولا ننفق هنا. Those who deserve more are those who are in need in whatever, in any country. And everybody in America is by default rich or good or is in no need. And other people go the other extreme. No. Any money here should be spent only in here. We should never send any money to anywhere. Why do we have both of them is wrong. If you are aware of somebody who is in need, especially if they are closer to you, especially if they are orphans or needy or somebody who qualifies more than others, especially if he sees you. ألم يذكر الله تبارك وتعالى لنا قصة أصحاب الجنة في سورة القلم ويعني أن اغدوا على حربكم قادرين فانطلقوا وهم يتخافتون أن لا يدخلنها اليوم عليكم مسكين. They got together and they were secretly planning to go in the morning and get the fruits from their garden before anybody of the masakeen, of the needy, would come and look. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, He will make everybody rich. He will make everybody in no need. Why would you plan and do ala haqqikum, you know, go secretly first thing in the morning and do not let any of those needy know about your plans? What happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the story that فَأَصْبَحَتْ كَالصَّرِيمِ. You know, when they come to it, when they saw it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent like a fire on it from the sky. It become completely destroyed. When they saw it, قَالُوا إِنَّا لَضَالُّونَ. Maybe we got a wrong way. This is not our, it doesn't look like our garden. It should be something else, somewhere else. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us, إِنَّمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ الْمَالَ لِإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ عِبَادَتِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us more. So we spend, so we take care of others. Let's go after them. Not them going after us. No, we should go after them. It's so good to spend in the masjid, to give to the masjid for zakat, so they spend it on the poor. So good to spend on other organizations who take care of orphans. Beautiful. But along with that, we need to try ourselves. Go find the poor. Go find the needy. A poor is not somebody who is homeless. We do have homeless. We do have people who go hungry. But somebody who is trying to make the ends meet, we have those in our community. We need to take care of them. إن مسحة على شعر يتيم كافية لأن تكون مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كهاتين في الجنة. كافية أن تعطى بكل شعرة حسنة. You know, you go just rub the hair of one of the orphans, as in the hadith, for each single hair that touches your hand, you get a reward حسنة from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وهو مرقق للقلب وكذا. إذا أردت أن يرق قلبك فاذهب إلى المقبرة وامسح رأس اليتيم. If you want your heart, you know, it's harsh and you want it to be soft, go visit the graveyard and see the orphans and deal with them and rub their hair and take care of them. كافر اليتيم وكفى به أجرا. يقول ابن بطال أيضا المالكي إنه حقيق على كل مسلم إذا سمع هذا الحديث إن أراد أن يكون مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الجنة كهاتين أن يعني يطبق هذا الحديث. He said, every Muslim who hears this hadith when النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says, me, Prophet ﷺ speaking, أنا وكافر يتيم, me and the one who takes care, who sponsors the orphan, will be like those. وأشار بالسبابة والوسطى وفرج بينهما. And he صلى الله عليه وسلم, you make this sign using the index finger and the middle finger, will be as close as those in Jannah with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So if we want to be as close as this with the Prophet ﷺ in Jannah, let's take care of the orphans and the needy. And there are so many in the countries where we came from, in here, everywhere. Let's take care of them. Let's go after them. سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً, secretly and publicly. We do it secretly so for our ikhlas and sincerity. And we do it publicly in front of people so people would also join us and do like us. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين الآثمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله رب العالمين فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي ويقول عز من قائل يسألونك ماذا ينفقون قل ما أنفقتم من خير فللوالدين والأقربين واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل. They ask you what to spend. How should they spend? Who should qualify? They said, tell them, whatever you spend of goodness, it should go first for the parents and the closest of your relatives and the اليتامى, the orphan and the needy and the wayfarers. وما تفعلوا من خير, whatever you do of goodness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of what you do. وآتوا اليتامى أموالهم. And so many ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so many ahadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving us how much reward you get because you take care of those who have, you know, the least amongst the communities. وهو ينفع للإنسان حري بمن تعامل مع يتيم أن يعني يقدر حاله كأنه, نسأل الله أن يحفظنا وأولادنا وأهلنا والمسلمين, كأن أولاده يعني كأن أولاده في مكان هذا الولد. والله تبارك وتعالى يعد على من فعل خيرا خاصة ليتيم أو كذا. قال في سورة الكهف وأما الجدار فكان لغلامين يتيمين في المدينة. قال وكان أبوهما صالحا. قالوا الجد السابع. The seventh grandfather used to be righteous, and that's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى in Surah Al-Kahf, the cave, he said, because of that, Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent Al-Khadr, a prophet, according to some narrations, to along with Musa عليه السلام, to rebuild this wall and to keep their treasure and their fortune, just because the great, great, great seventh grandfather, he was righteous. Be righteous. Take care of others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you. وَمَنْ نَفَّسَ عَمْ مُؤْمِنٍ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ الدُّنْيَا. There's so many ahadith. If you relieve, cause somebody to be relieved from any of the calamities or problems that's happening to him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of, will do this likewise, will do the similar thing with you in the day of judgment when you are in distress and you are in need for help. يحشر الناس يوم القيامة أعرى ما كانوا قط وأجوع ما كانوا قط وأظمأ ما كانوا قط وأنصب ما كانوا قط فمن كسى لله عز وجل كساه الله، ومن أطعم لله عز وجل أطعمه الله، ومن سقى لله عز وجل سقاه الله، ومن عفى لله عز وجل أعفاه الله. People will come in the day of judgment the most hungry, not having any clothes, not having anything, and whoever offers food in this time to somebody, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him food. Whoever give clothes to somebody, Allah will give him clothes on that day. Whoever does so many things for the sake of Allah in this life, he will be dealt with likewise in the day of judgment. فَنَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى أَنْ يعني يُحَنِّنَ قُلُوبَنَا عَلَى الضُّعَفَاءِ وَعَلَى الْفُقَرَاءِ وَعَلَى الْمَسَاكِينِ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us soft enough to accommodate those who are in need, those who are poor, those who have the least. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala اجعلنا من المنفقين ومن المتصدقين ومن المحسنين. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who spend, who always give in charity, those who take care of the orphan, those who take care of those who are in need. نسأل الله تبارك وتعالى أن يعيننا وإياكم على كل خير. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا مولانا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. وعباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي. Two ways quickly for you to spend. Your masjid is always in need because we have courses running. Alhamdulillah, you're always generous. We have targets for the monthly thing. We don't want to come back to you, keep coming back to you. If you want, you can give your card number. If you did it, that's beautiful. And if you want to increase it, that's also more beautiful. But if you didn't do it before, please take the chance to do that. It could be $5, $10, $100, whatever you can give, but make it on a monthly basis. And your numbers and everything, card is very secure, and it's going to come as a sadaqah jariyah for you, inshallah. More importantly, is take care of those who are in need of our community here and then elsewhere, inshallah.